In this video, we explain bagging and boosting. Bagging and boosting are types of machine learning methods known as ensemble learning. Both methods build a bunch of models and combine the predictions resulting from those models for better performance. Ensemble learning is based on a principle that many predictors are better than one predictor, and it is often the case. Bagging stands for bootstrap aggregating. You start bagging by generating a bunch of random samples with replacement from your training data. Then you train a model for each of these samples, resulting in many models. Finally, you combine the predicted outcomes from all these models. If the target variable is categorical, then you take the majority vote of the predicted class, and that will be your prediction. If the target variable is numerical, then you calculate the average of predictions from all the models. A random forest is an example of a bagging algorithm. It consists of a collection of decision trees, thus it is referred as a forest. Additional randomness is introduced during the training of each tree. Only a random subset of all available features is visible at each tree node. Consequently, a random forest is robust against overfitting, since different trees see different parts of the data space. Unlike bagging, where all the models are trained in parallel, in boosting, a bunch of models are trained sequentially. You start out with your first model, which likely produces some errors in prediction. Then your next model will focus on those data points that resulted in errors by giving more weights to those data points with errors. Then your third model will focus on the errors from your second model, and so on. You get the idea. You build a sequence of models that focus on the errors from the previous model. You repeat this process and finally combine a series of models into a single prediction. Gradient boosted trees is an example of a boosting algorithm. At each step, a shallow decision tree, known as a weak learner, is trained on the training data emphasizing errors from the previous step. The resulting tree is added to the current model to update the model. The process is repeated, typically 50 to 100 iterations, to generate the final model. More iterations will likely lead to overfitting. The main difference between bagging and boosting is in the order of the model application. All together in parallel for bagging and sequentially for boosting. This leads to a heavy computational load and memory usage for bagging, but to lighter memory and CPU usages during sequential training sessions for boosting. The ensemble learning methods described in this video are available in KNIME Analytics platform. Nodes are available for both classification and regression analyses. In this video, we have shown how bagging and boosting work. We have shown that multiple models are trained in parallel in bagging, whereas models are trained sequentially in boosting. We have also shown KNIME nodes for ensemble learning.